Hello there, welcome to IQ Pop. Today I'll discuss about operators in C. Okay, so by nature there is three kind of operator: arithmetic operator, relational operator and logical operators. And they're based on number of operands one operator handles or needs. Based on that, there is three kind of operators like unary operators, binary operator, trinary operator. In unary operator, there is only one operand. In binary operator, there is two operand. In trinary operator, we need three operand or three expressions. Now, assignment operator I have shown here separately because it is used widely in C and different reasons in different places. So, let's try it. Hash. Include stdio dot h int main return 0. Now say int a equal to 5. Okay. Another thing we can do, okay, let's print type %d comma a, so it will print the value of a. Okay, so here on use of equal to our assignment operator. Now another thing we can do that is quite interesting is a equal to b equal to c equal to d equal to 5. Now any of them, if I want to print, say I'm printing c. Now let's see what happens. Compile it. Let's declare them a, b, c, d and run this thing from here. Compile. Here c, okay, a equal to 5 and c equal to 5. It is displaying. Okay. So these are other application of assignment operator you all know, so I'm not discussing anymore. Now these are the arithmetic operations: plus, minus, multiplication, division. This is this modulo operation, this is increment and this is decrement operators. So all of them we have used previously in our previous codes, so I'm not demonstrating them. Now relational operator, I'll show you the demonstration of relational operators. The relational operators returns in terms of true or false. It basically they compare that if two values are equal, then it returns yes, that is true. So if not equal, it returns no. Say a greater than b. If it is really a greater than b, it will return true. If it is not, it will return false. Now see what happens. Say we have a equal to already 5, so take b equal to 55. Okay, and let's take another variable r. Now we'll do r equal to a equal b and print the value of r here. Okay, so run it. See, it is displaying that r equal to 0. That means a equal to b. No, that is false. False means 0 and true means 1. So if I write here a less than b, that is true. So now it is we find that yes, r equal to 1 now, so it is true. Anything else you can check, that is a greater than b? Zero, that means no, a is not greater than b. Next you can try, say a not equal to b, it will be true. Yes, r equal to 1, that means it is true. What is that is there in relation operator, less than equal to and greater than equal to, also you can try the same way. I'm not demonstrating right now. So next are the logical operator, and, or, and not. So in our previous lecture we had discussed about and, or, and not. Take another variable here, say c equal to 75. Now we can do something like this, say if r equal to, now we are checking that a not equal to b and give a condition here b less than c. So both are true and true equal to true, so it should return us true. Run it. Now you can see that r is coming 1, so it is true. Now what is the use of that not? We can simply make one part or result of one part to its inverse. If it is true, but we will consider it false. If it is false, we will consider it as true. Then we can add a not before it. So if I do that, see what happens. Now r is 0. Okay. Now weightwise operators. So this thing also I had discussed previously, but I had not given a demonstration. Now yes, 0 0 0, we know it. 0 1, if it is AND operation, bitwise AND, then it is 0. If it is 0 1 1, it is going to be 1. Say a equal to 5 equal to this, and I don't need c equal to something anymore. Okay, so now say r equal to a AND b, so we are going to display the result r. See, it is coming that r equal to 5, right? So like this, if a is r or, now see what result we get, it is 55. Okay, so this way we can use bitwise operators. This is a jar operator, this is your tilde operator, this is a right shift operator, this is left shift operator, and this is right shift operator. Now there is some other applications of or ways of using this assignment operator, a variant of assignment operator. We can say we have a and b and r. Now we can do, say if we want to add, okay, only equal to, we have already tried, say we want to add say 10 with a, so we can write it like this, 10. Okay, so we want to add this 10 to a. Now you see, display the value of a, what it is going to display, see, it is 15. So previously a was 5, now I have added 10, so it become 15. So in the same way, say I want to subtract 10 from a. You can see negative 5 is coming, alright? Multiplication. So a multiply with 10 equal 50, so it should display equal to 50. Yes, equal to 50 it is displaying. So in the same way, we can use the division. We can do mod operation also. So if we want to see a mod, say 2, and the result will again store back to a, okay, in this situation. So run it, so it should be 1. Yes, because if we divide 5 by 2, remainder is 1. That is what the modulus operation. Okay, in the same way we can do the other, use the other operation. size of and trinary operator. Size of operator returns size of some variable, some variable, say A we are having here. So we want to see what is the size of A on my machine. So we can write here size of A. One bracket is missing here. Okay. Now it is showing that size of A is 4 bytes. So this is the use of size of. Next is ambershand operator. We have already used. We want to display address of A. So ambershand operator is there, which retrieves the address of a variable from the memory. So ambershand A will display the address, and percent PM using here, it is used for displaying some address, P for pointer. Okay, so pointer holds the address. So see, it is displaying a hexadecimal number, so the which is address of A. Another is there, that is a trinary operator or question mark operator. How that is going to be used? Say we want to do apply some conditions. Say if B greater than A, then we will do B minus A. Otherwise, we will do A minus B. Okay? Or the reverse thing we can do. Say R equal to, want to check that out of A and B, which is greater, and we want to subtract the smaller number from the greater number. So how can we do that? So in that case, we'll first write the expression of checking that if A greater than B, question mark, if A greater than B, if yes, then you do A minus B. If no, then you do B minus A. Okay, so I'm going to get an integer result, R equal to some integer. Okay, so I'm displaying the value of R. Run it. So you can see it is returning 50. That means it has checked that A greater than B. No. Now, with every operator, there is associativity of the operator is first thing, and another thing is cause precedence of the operator. Now here we have arranged all the operators according to their precedence. Okay, so precedence means if there is mix of all these operators, which operator will get chance to evaluate first? So here the brackets and plus plus minus minus, okay, increment operators and dot operator, these are the having the highest precedence. And there is another thing related to that, each operator, that is the associativity. That means the at the time of evaluation of the operator, what will be the associativity? That means evaluation will be from left to right or right to left. So for all these operators, it is left to right associativity, plus minus not, and all these operators are having right to left. associativity, multiplication, and all these are being left to right. So in this way, there is a list, you can check it. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, share, and subscribe, and hang with me for getting more lectures and interesting topics.